So from what I've been hearing, Rod Wave's album, 150,000 sold first week, which is big numbers. This video, Tombstone, over 10 million views in a few days. It's about time. I took some time to listen to this guy and see what he's all about. Yes, I saw him in the XXL freestyles, but that's it. I've never heard one of his tunes. So that's about to change right now. Rod Wave, Tombstone reaction. Let's do this thing.
Damn, this motherfucker too crazy saucy. Let that shit ride, 88.
These producer tags are getting out of hand. That was about 10 seconds.
Too crazy saucy. Let that shit ride, 88.
When this shit over, it's over. I don't know what's after it or what's after, you know?
I keep my gun in my drawers, ducking the sad news. My phone say 7 missed calls, I know it's bad news. This life had left me so scarred, I'm knowing that's true. Remember, tongue got so hard, I got it tattooed.
Jesus. I was a bit worried at first when he was truly mumbling. I was like, I'm pretty sure this guy is more of a singer, right? And then, of course, he does sing. 7 missed calls, I know it's bad news. It's quite a hard-hitting lyric straight away. There's something about a lyric that can paint a picture and really set a tone, along with the way that the beat is being constructed with the guitar and sort of minor key. Okay.
My phone say 7 missed calls, I know it's bad news. This life had left me so scarred, I'm knowing that's true. Remember, time got so hard, I got it tattooed. I painted no shows, but made some bread. I gotta keep the family fed. Look, just talk to Pops about the feds. I ain't gonna lie, he had me scared. I feel him coming, nigga. I'll keep on running, nigga. If we go down bad, keep it a honey, nigga. My girl all in my ear screaming, spend some time. I promise I'll be here when I can get some time. Right now, I gotta get what's mine.
Right, from a musical point of view, this is quite a cinematic video already, and I'm trying to figure out if the little boy in the video is Rod, I'm assuming, and that is the case. Yeah, really nice. It's so nice to hear a guy in this melodic space. We hear so much of this, like, melodic trap music. I call it that. I don't know. I mean, this wouldn't really sound like trap music anyway, but he can sing. I'm so bored of people who can't sing that just use auto-tune, and it just, I mean, to be honest, it kind of sounds terrible. This guy can sing. It sounds nice to my ears.
I'll be thugging to the end of time. And fuck these niggas cause they lame. Since they love saying my name. Make sure you write the truest in the motherfucking game. On my tombstone and bury me. By the river they will carry me. Finally I'll be resting in peace. Finally, finally, I'll get to fly away. Somewhere, someday. Fuck these niggas cut they lame. Since they love saying my name. Make sure you write the truest in the game. On my tombstone ain't burying me. By the river they will carry me.
Man, it's a heavy video. A very, very heavy video. I'm assuming this is Rod talking about his own upbringing and what he went through. I'm assuming, yeah, domestic violence, unhappy household. But musically, you've got the sort of gospel choir coming in there, the way it's harmonizing. It sounds amazing, and it actually sounds different to what I was expecting. To be honest, I don't know what I was expecting, but this is almost like an R&B track. But yeah, quite emotionally resonant so far.
Finally, I'll be resting in peace. Finally, finally.
The little boy got shot by the police?
I'm a young
Jesus, man. No, I'm not very good with stuff where little boys get hurt. Being a dad of two little boys, so that's always going to hit quite hard. Just looking into the lyrics, it seems that the song is mainly about, you know, wanting to show his greatness and show his worth while he's still here. And that's understandable because so many people have passed away young, especially so many young black people. And in a video, you've got this kid who's going through this awful situation, and then he's killed by the police, he's got his hood up, you know, obviously referencing real life. If there's something that I've missed there, please let me know in the comments. This is how I'm interpreting it anyway. It's a deeply sad video, it's a deeply sad song, but it's, I think, a slightly more emotionally uplifting song in a strange sort of way, just because of the beauty of it. The video is just deeply sad, and like I say, anything with a young boy getting hurt like that is always going to affect me massively. But yeah, just let the rest of the song play. It's a striking visual anyway, just Rod waving the snow there, it's a beautiful shot. But to be honest, I'm mainly impressed by the sort of heart of the song, the spirit of the song, the musicianship of the song. I went in assuming it was going to be something else entirely, and I was pleasantly surprised. And there is no doubt of how rich a timbre of his voice is, how well it suited the beat, how it felt like a song that had been constructed. So many songs these days, they feel like there's a beat put there, and then somebody comes in and they either rap over the top or they do this melodic thing over the top, and there's a bit of a disconnect there. It doesn't really feel like a song, almost feels like a bit of a product. Sometimes they're put together very quickly. That felt like something else. That felt like a bit of a moment. And it's made me very interested in Rod as an artist. I know he's just put his album out, so, you know, let me know if that's an album that I need to be checking out in full down in the comments. But yeah, Rod Wave, man. I can see why this is blowing up. I can see why his album has sold so well. And yeah, definitely, definitely one I'm going to be keeping an eye on for sure. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching the reaction. I've been John Denton. I'll catch you all very soon. All right, peace.